Cool.
There's a lot of ways. I'll talk about the liquid cooling. Maybe you can talk about the air cooling.
Yeah.
So we did mention that pump two-phase application, which was for data center cooling. That's kind of the new wave of handling these really high heat load, high performance computing type of data center applications. And the reason pump two-phase is really suitable for that application is that it's capable of absorbing a lot of energy with a small amount of energy input. So it's above ambient cooling solution. So a cooling tower or some ultimate rejection system is needed on the roof of your building. But at the server level, you're really picking up the most amount of energy or heat per unit of energy input into the system using pump two-phase cooling or some sort of liquid to vapor cooling technique. And so when energy efficiency is really the name of the game in data centers, that gets you where you need to be at the server level.
Even if you have chilled water in the building, a lot of people are not going to feel comfortable putting chilled water into the server area. So a heat exchanger to a two-phase pumping system, one of the benefits of that refrigerant is if you have a leak, it'll leak as a gas. So you're not going to have conductive liquid all over electronics if there is a leak. So I know that pump two-phase, even with a chilled water system, is still kind of preferred at the load. And like you said, with a constant temperature across the heat sink, it really allows for optimized equipment. From an air system side, hot aisle, cold aisle might be terminology you're familiar with. And this is really about making sure that the cold air from the crack units or whatever the air handler is called in those system is delivered to the inlet of the equipment. And then the hot aisle would be where the racks blow everything out. So, one of the things I've seen in some kind of tactical systems is you have a hodgepodge of equipment. Some have fans in the front pulling in, some have fans in the back pulling in. And so now you don't have all the equipment even pulling from the same side. So very quickly, you can have a piece of equipment that gets the heat from another piece of equipment and isn't happy, even though, the air handler attached to the system is of adequate capacity. The air can't get to the electronics, you have trouble. So definitely taking into account the direction of airflow and management of the airflow for the electronics is a big thing.
And our last product, coming back to the energy efficiency part for data centers that we didn't talk about today, is a product called a wraparound heat pipe, heat exchanger. And this is actually incorporated directly into the air handlers for the crack units. And what it's helping to do is to enhance the dehumidification of the system so you can do some pre-cooling, some free reheat on the system. We also have air-to-air energy exchange products where you're recycling that air through the data center and you tend to be throwing away cold air that's already been conditioned. You can use that energy to pre-cool the hot air from the outside without needing to input any more energy into the system. And so it can improve the overall energy efficiency of your data center, even if you're still using air cooling. It could even work with the liquid cooling systems. So that's quite a lot of technologies for data center applications.